Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 13.6 Beta 2 has been out for a couple weeks, and oddly at this point we haven't seen an update from Apple as far as Beta 3. Now tomorrow we'll see iOS 14 Beta 1, so maybe they're waiting till later this week. It's really hard to say, but I don't think many people are going to care too much about iOS 13.6 once iOS 14 is out. Now I've been using iOS 13.6 Beta 2 on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, as well as an iPad Air 2, but I don't have that here since I'm outside. But I wanted to talk about how it's been for me over the past couple of weeks, how it's been for you based off the YouTube community poll that now has over 10,000 votes, which is great. And also I wanted to talk about battery life and some bugs and things like that. Now in general, performance has been great. In fact, most people say performance is great and they've really had no issues. So performance is fine, even on older devices, the 6S Plus or the 7 or any of those devices seem to have excellent battery life. However, the other devices such as the iPad Air 2 seem to be okay. They are a little bit slow from time to time, but that device is pretty slow in general. Now, as far as issues I've had, well, mail seems to be okay, but it continues to have a few issues. So for example, here's the inbox of one of my email accounts, and if I hit this button, it should show me all the unread email. And this only works some of the time. So sometimes I hit it and it shows me just unread email. Sometimes I hit it and it doesn't show me unread email. It shows me everything. So that button doesn't seem to be working. And I know some people still continue to have the issue where they'll have a notification button here with everything going on as far as the amount of emails they have. They go into their email, it has to check it again, and it just doesn't work right in general. And so it seems like Apple still has to work out the bugs with mail. Now, occasionally I've been seeing lockups in things like Telegram, and there's no way to really fix it. It just seems to be locking up regularly, and specific apps will do that. Now, I don't know if the app needs to be updated, but I haven't had settings freeze or anything like that. So any Apple-specific apps seem to be fine. But whatever it is going on, third-party apps sometimes freeze. And so those are the only issues I've personally have, but some people have been saying that things like Wi-Fi dropping off seem to be normal. And so I don't know if Apple updated the Wi-Fi stack so that maybe it's not working properly with certain types of routers. And I've seen that in the past where maybe your Wi-Fi just doesn't work properly if you have a Cisco router and then Cisco needs to update their routers. So it's hard to say exactly what's going on, but hopefully this gets resolved quickly. Now, battery life, most people are saying it's really good. In fact, my battery life's pretty decent. So if we go to battery, we'll take a look at battery health. You'll see my battery health is 97%. And battery life, most people are saying it's pretty good. It's as good as 13.5.1 or better than that. And it's over 70% saying that. So if we take a look at some of the battery life I've had, you'll see this one is 4 hours of screen on time, 12 hours and 58 minutes of screen off time, and I used under 50% of the battery. And so what this means is basically I can easily get 10 to 12 hours of screen on time depending how I'm using it. So my battery life has been pretty consistent as far as it being good. I'm happy with it and I'm glad that it seems to be what it was when it was new. Now, as far as iOS 14 is concerned, well, I can't imagine a whole lot of people are going to care too much about 13 after 14 is shown, but iOS 14 won't come out until the fall when it's September or October at this point. So expect new features, but it's more about stability. I think we're going to see a huge stability improvement, maybe a change in the way Apple does betas, and maybe just a better overall experience. There will be some new apps, there will be some new features and things like that, new emoji, of course, but nothing really spectacular. So don't get too excited, but I think there'll be some other things that we see as well. Now you can see there's over 10,000 votes at this point, so I really appreciate anyone that's voted. It's been a couple weeks at this point, but you'll see 14% of you said that it's great, 2% say that it's terrible, 4% say okay but some bugs, and 59% are still on iOS 13.5.1 or older. And so what that means to me is you're either waiting for a newer, more stable version, 13.6, or you want to make sure that you can still jailbreak. And then 21% of you are using Android. And that number is kind of surprising to me, so I don't know if that's just people switching to Android or just more people using Android or seeing these polls. Now there's 168 comments, so let's take a look at some of them and then see what you had to say over this past week. Now, hopefully in the future, when I do these update videos and I do these polls, I would love to see what version you're on, as it really helps kind of figure out what the data is here as well. Now here you can see it says, on my iPhone XS Max is okay, but with some bugs. I'm having battery issues on my iPhone 7 Plus and iPad Air 3, but that could be iOS 13.5.1 or iOS 13.6 Beta 2. I'd love to know which version you're on. iOS 13.6 runs great on iPhone 7. It's really good. I have no issues. Everything is smooth and fast, no heating issues, and no battery drain. I'm happy now. My device is iPhone 8. iPhone XS, iOS 13.6, some bugs in notification sound, and sometimes Safari gets freeze until restart the app. And I have seen other freezes, people reporting issues with Safari, but it's not too many. iPhone 6S, iOS 13.6, works great, but I still have issues with the control center sliding not working. Not a new issue, only never fixed by Apple. Works again after restarting the phone. It comes and goes. I haven't heard of that on the 6S or 6S Plus, but make sure you report that in the feedback app. It's working great on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. No issues on 13.6 beta. So far, so good on my XS Max. No issues to complain about as of yet. Battery is good. Left my jailbreak for this update. Got bored of my jailbreak. I'm fine until iOS 14 comes out. And I think that's it for new comments, since not as many people are excited about iOS 13.6 since iOS 14 is right around the corner. And so I'm looking forward to what we have with iOS 14, maybe a new iMac as well, and some other things. So I'm really looking forward to that. And I'd love to hear what you're most excited about with iOS 14 as well. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.